Testing the sound.
Good evening and Shabbat Shalom, everyone.
Shabbat Shalom.
That was almost fantastic, but let's do it again because we need more Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, everyone.
Shabbat Shalom.
Welcome to Congregation Beth Ahabah. We're so glad you're here. I'm Rabbi Scott Nagel. This is Cantor Sarah Beck Berman. Our music director, Natan Berenstein, is at the piano. And up here on the bima, we have our wonderful Beth Ahabah Choir. We're here to come together as a community and celebrate Shabbat, and I'm so thankful that you're all here in support of each other and this community. For those of you unfamiliar with our prayer book, Mishkan Tefillah, the most important thing is that you have one. It opens from right to left. On each page, you'll find traditional Hebrew prayers, transliteration of the Hebrew into English characters, and translation of the Hebrew into English as well. We encourage you to use any and all that are comfortable and meaningful for you, regardless of what it is that we are doing up here on the bima. Please note the book is presented on occasion in a two-page layout. While we'll do our best to announce page numbers throughout the service, if you are looking for the continuation of a prayer or the end of a prayer or you're simply lost, just turn the page. We're going to begin our worship this evening on page 10. Page 10 with Hine Matov. How good and how pleasant it is that brothers and sisters dwell together. We continue now as we turn back to page two, and we kindle the lights of Shabbat together. Please join with me. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav v'tivanu lahadlik ner shel Shabbat. Blessed are you, Adonai our God, sovereign of the universe, who hallows us with mitzvot, commanding us to kindle the light of Shabbat. Continue on page 5. Page 5, as Cantor leads us in Kiddush, blessing over wine or grape juice, sanctifying the Sabbath day. Thank you. L'chaim. Delicious. We continue now on page 28, as we rise together for our call to worship Baruch Hu.
We turn to page 31 for our prayer for the evening sky. Page 31, at the top of the page, I ask my customary question, what phase is the moon in? Anybody know? Yeah, it's just about full. Technically, tonight it might still be a waxing gibbous moon, but tomorrow for sure it'll be a full moon, and the full moon usually lasts for a couple of days. So the full moon means it's the middle of the month of Cheshvan, and we're reaching that mid part of the month. So we think about the moon, we think about the stars, and we think about all of the works of creation visible at night as we say our prayer for the evening at the top of page 31. Praise to you, Adonai, our God, from whom the evening flows. Your wisdom sets the way on which time and season glide. Your breath guides the sail of the stars. Creator of the tide of time and light, you guide the current of day into night. As heaven spans to infinity, you set its course for eternity. Praise to you, Adonai, our God, from whom the evening flows. Baruch ata Adonai, hama'ariv aravim.
We continue now as we remain standing and turn to page 34, as we prepare for Shema. Hear, O Israel, Adonai is our God, Adonai is one. Be seated. We continue with Via Hafta, page 36.
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha bechol levavecha uchol nafshecha uvechol meodecha ve'hayu hadvarim ha'ele Asher anochi mitzvecha Shinantam Levanecha, Bedi Bartahabam, Beshivtecha Beitecha, Uvlechtecha Baderech, Ushochbecha Uvkumecha, Ukshartam Leot Al Yadecha, Behayu Letotafot Beinecha. Uchtav tam al mezuzot betecha uvisharecha lema'an tizkeru va'asitem et kol mitzvotai v'item kedoshim le'alechem ani Adonai Elohechem Asher hoseiti echem me'eretz Mitzrayim liot lachem Elohim ani Adonai Elohechem Adonai Elohechem. Amen.
We read together in the middle of page 39. Together. In a world torn by violence and pain, a world far from wholeness and peace, give us the courage to say, Adonai, there is one God in heaven and earth. The high heavens declare your glory. May earth reveal your justice and love. From bondage in Egypt we were delivered. At Sinai we bound ourselves to your way. Inspired by prophets and instructed by sages, time and again we overcame oppressive forces. Though our failings are many and our faults are great, it has been our glory to bear witness to our God, keeping alive in dark ages your vision of a world redeemed. Let us continue to work for the day when the nations will be one and at peace. Then shall we rejoice as Israel did, singing on the shores of the sea. We continue on page 40 with our song of deliverance, Michamocha. Continue now on page 44, as we celebrate, key word, celebrate Shabbat with Vishamru.
Yismichu.
Okay, I'm sorry, Cantor. Yismichu it is.
Shabbat.
Shabbat. Yismechu u'malechutecha. Yismechu u'malechutecha. Shomrei Shabbat b'kolei.
Come now to the central portion of our worship, Tefillah. We turn together to page 46. Just to let everyone know, this is one of those sections that we are in a two-page layout. So we are on page 46, and we rise together for Tefillah.
Wrote,
Shim HaKadosh, Ukdoshim Bechol Yom Yehaleluha Seva, Baruch Ata Adonai Ha'el HaKadosh.
You may be seated. We read together on the bottom of page 57. Page 57. Together, you are with us in our prayer, our love, and our doubt, in our longing to feel your presence and do your will. You are the still, clear voice within us. Therefore, O God, when doubt troubles us, when anxiety makes us tremble, when pain clouds the mind, we look inward for the answer to our prayers. There may we find you, and there find courage, insight, and endurance. And let our worship bring us closer to one another, that all Israel and all who seek you may find new strength for your service. Baruch ata Adonai, she'odcha levadcha ba'irah na'avod. We continue now on page 60 with our first prayer for peace. Shalom Rav. Take a few moments now of silent prayer and meditation, either the words on the page or the prayers of our own hearts.
We continue with our next prayer for peace. Oseh Shalom on page 62 at the bottom of the page.
We dedicate this moment of prayer to those in need of healing. On this Shabbat, Congregation Beth Ahabah prays for the healing of Bob Marks, Seth Ginther, Neil Gleiberman, Jeffrey Teeger, Charles LeBeau, Yaakov Kogan, Rivka Kogan, Colton Richard Schultz Boyd, Max Staten Parfit, David Talheimer, Doug Heidman, Rabbi Jack Spiro, Randall Markham Berman, Andrea Barnadette Bean, Lorraine Badovsky, Kathy Marks, Paul Balanoff, Marilyn Flax, Audrey Landers, and Alan Arkaba. If there's anyone else here who'd like to share their own name, the name of a friend, family member, loved one, anyone at all who could benefit from our prayers of healing, I ask you to share the name aloud or in your hearts as I scan the room. To them we add and think of all those who have been harmed in the war between Hamas and Israel. And as we pray for their healing, we pray for the healing of all those in our world who need healing. And we pray for the healing of our broken world. As together we turn to our Shabbat programs, for Misha Berach, a prayer for healing.
Hear our prayer.
lechem etchem. Hamakom yenachem etchem. Betuch shor avilei tzion Yerushalayim. Betuch shor avilei tzion Yerushalayim. May the one who dwells in every place, may the one who dwells in every place comfort you and bring you peace among all those who mourn. Comfort you and bring you peace among all those who mourn.
Peace. Peace is a complicated word. In Hebrew, the word for peace is shalom. It's used as a greeting, meaning that we're wishing peace to those who come and go. Shalom comes from the root for wholeness, completion, shlemut. So tonight, as a sermon and song, we will focus on peace and some of the things that peace can mean for us. As we just heard in Rabbi Hannah Tiferet Siegel's setting of Hamakom Yenachem, words that we traditionally say to people who are in mourning, who have experienced a recent loss, sometimes when we say peace, we also mean comfort. When we lose someone, as many of us have, we ask that the departed rest in peace and that those of us still living are able to find peace. Another thing that peace can mean for us is rest, as in today, Shabbat, the day of rest. So here are just a few songs, just a few of the many songs of peace that are connected to Shabbat. Firstly, as we enter Shabbat, we say Shalom Aleichem. Everyone say Shalom Aleichem.
Shalom Aleichem.
Which means peace be upon you as a greeting. And this is a song that is in our prayer books on page 24, if you wish to follow along. Shalom Aleichem is our greeting for the angels that we imagine are presaging the arrival of the Shabbat Queen. And we greet the angels in peace. And at the end of the song, we wish the angels in peace. We wish the angels peace as they go. So if you wish to follow along again, it's on page 24 in our Sidurim.
Shalom Aleichem, Malachei Hasharet, Malachei Elyon, Mimelech, Malachei Hamelachim, Hakadosh Baruch Hu. Boachem leshalom, malachei hashalom, malachei elyon. Mimelech malachei hamelachim, hakadosh baruch hu. Baruchuni leshalom, malachei hashalom, malachei elyon. Mimelech malachei hamelachim, hakadosh baruch hu. Tzedchem leshalom, malachei hashalom, malachei elyon. Mimelech malachei hamelachim, hakadosh baruch hu.
That melody written by Nava Tehillah, Daphna Rosenberg in Nava Tehillah in Jerusalem. Next, skipping ahead to Shabbat morning, we already sang some of the prayers for peace in Shabbat evening, like Shalom Rav. The prayer for peace during the Shabbat morning Amidah is called Sim Shalom, which means grant peace. And the words for this are also in our prayer books on page 140. It's not a command performance, but if you want to see them. Sim Shalom means grant peace. So we're not just greeting people anymore. We're saying, God, we're not messing around here. Grant us some peace. This melody is by Julie Silver.
Sim Shalom Tov Uvracha. Sim Shalom Tov Uvracha. Chesed v'rachamim, chen v'chesed v'rachamim,
as we conclude Shabbat, which, you know, it's still Friday night, but we'll imagine, there's a song from the Sephardi tradition called El Dio Alto, which means God on high. It's traditional to sing this song after Havdalah, as we end Shabbat and we're easing ourselves into the rest of the week. And because it's in Ladino, I'll tell you first what it means in 1 second. It says, God on high, with God's assistance, will provide for us that we should see no evil, us and all of Israel. Blessed be God who gave us Shabbat, a day of rest, us and all of Israel. I pray to God that God will always be in our thoughts, that we will never lack bread and wine, us and all of Israel. O compassionate God, send us the Redeemer, that this should be a good sign, a siman tov, us and all of Israel. Now, this song does not have the word shalom in it, but for me, this song has always brought peace. And it's a prayer for compassion, safety, rest, and sustenance, which really are all the hallmarks of peace.
El Dio alto con su gracia mos mande mucha ganancia, non veamos mal ni ansia, a nos y a todo Israel. Bendito el abastado que vos dio. Rojo al Dio de continuo que esté en nuestro tino, non nos mande.
The first phrase of the song was God on high. There is another song written by a modern Jewish composer, relatively modern, which begins that way. God on high, hear my prayer. In my need, you have always been there. Broadway fans know which one I mean. The English language version of this song from Les Miserables, which is called Bring Him Home, doesn't use the word peace. But an Israeli named Ehud Manor, famous poet and writer, translated this Broadway song into Hebrew, and the chorus, instead of Bring Him Home, is Bishalom, in peace. And I want to share that with you. And to bring us home, let's close our songs of peace tonight with a familiar one. This version of Oseh Shalom, which can be found on the prayer book in page 62. We were just there. This version of Oseh Shalom was composed by Israeli composer Nurit Hirsch for the first Hasidic Song Festival, which was held in 1969, and which won third place in that festival. And it's probably familiar to many of you.
Oh, say shalom, imroma, uya, say shalom, aleinu, ve'al ko Israel, ve'imru.
shalom, yaase shalom, shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael, yaase shalom, yaase shalom, shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael, yaase shalom, yaase shalom, shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael, yaase shalom, yaase shalom, shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael, yaase shalom, yaase shalom, shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael.
Amidst all the challenges, amidst all the suffering, amidst everything that life has to throw at us, peace is something we come back to every single week, and if you pray in the prayer book, even every single day, multiple times a day, we pray for peace, we hope for peace, and we work towards peace. So this week, let us use Shabbat, our day of rest, as a way to rest and renew ourselves, to prepare us and enable us to continue that work for peace the next day. Amen.
As the choir's rejoining us up here on the bima, I want to draw everyone's attention to my tie. It is a tie of sharks, because the cantor loves sharks. It is my cantor appreciation tie. And I say that because the cantor and I were talking, and I said to her, I'm done with talking. What I need is some prayers for peace. And she said, I got you. And she does. And I figured if I needed to hear some prayers for peace, so do we all. And she got me, and she got all of us. And thank you. Thank you very much. We'll return to our Sidurim, to our prayer books, as we turn to page 282. Page 282. And I open the ark, Cantor will open the ark, as we rise together for Aleinu. As we turn together to page 294, page 294, we remember those we've loved and lost. And on this Shabbat, Congregation Beth Ahabah marks the recent passing of Brenda Sue Emrach, Marilyn Spiro, and Inga Greenwald. We recall the Yahrzeit anniversary of Harry Aronson, Sybil Bassell, Margaret Florsheim Baum, Samuel Berlin, Fred M. Block, Sadie Bach, Aaron Eichel, Herbert Flax, Arthur Forrest, Herbert Freed, Morton N. Gary, Millie Gilman, Dorothy G. Goldstone, Isaac Gorbati, Harry Grandis, Nathan M. Heller, Mina Hirsch, Hazel Marks Kaplan, Bernard Kastenbaum, Larry Kitt, Don Levy, Beverly Litauer, Edward McGrill, Rosalie M. Marcuse, Otis Moran, Lawrence Nachman, Jeanette M. Pfaff, Shirley P. Plotkin, Moselle's Rapp, Clara Richmond, Paul Rogers, Betty Schloss, Bernard Schwartz, Honey Shapiro, Joan Shepherd, Joel Michael Singer, Fanny C. Straws, Mary Zachary. If there's anyone else here who's observing Shiva, the 7 days following death, Shloshim, the 30 days following death, or if you're observing the Yahrzeit anniversary of a loved one's death, or if there's simply someone whom you'd like to recall and remember today, I ask you to share their name aloud or in your hearts as I scan the room. We remember also all those people who have died on both sides of the border as a result of the terror carried out by Hamas. We remember them now. They live in our hearts. And we pray that their memories will always be for us abiding blessings. At this time, I invite all who are in mourning to please rise. All who are observing a Yahrzeit to please rise. And as is our custom here at Congregation Beth Ahabah, the entire community to rise in support of one another and in memory of all who came before us as we turn to the Mourner's Kaddish together, page 294. Yitgadal v'yitkadash shemei rabbah. B'alma divrach yirutev yamlik malchute, b'chayachon of yomechon uv'chayed kol beit Yisrael, b'agala uzman kariv yimru amen, yehesh me rabam v'orach le'olam rameh omaya, yitbarak v'yishtabak v'yitba'ar v'yitroman v'yitnase, v'yithadar v'yitale v'yitalal shemei d'kudusha brechu, Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata, tush bechata v'nechemata, damiran b'yoma v'yimru amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya, v'chayim aleinu v'yokol Yisrael, v'yimru amen. Ose shalom b'mromav, hu ya'ase shalom, aleinu v'yokol Yisrael, v'yimru amen. May there be abundant peace from heaven and life for us, for all Israel, and all the world. And let us say together, Amen. May the one who creates harmony on high bring peace to us, to all Israel, and all who dwell on earth. And may God comfort all who mourn among us, as we say together once again,
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated. We have a few announcements.
Yes, we do have a few announcements. Firstly, Shabbat Shalom once again to everyone here in our sanctuary and everyone who's watching at home on our YouTube channel. Thank you so much one more time to the Beth Ahabah Choir for sharing your voices with us and always to Natan for everything. Tomorrow is a busy day. Tomorrow, Saturday, the 28th of October, beginning at 9 a.m., crowd favorite Tat Shabbat returns for those people 5 and younger and the adults who drive them around. Then, at 10:30 a.m., there is a guitar workshop with Rabbi Nagel. At 12:30 p.m., there's a Talmud Lunch and Learn, which will be both here and on Zoom. It'll be a hybrid learning. And at 2 p.m., our young adults group, YAC, Young Adult Community Kibbutz, will be meeting for a Shabbat walk at Lewis Ginter Botanical Gardens. And if you want to know more about that, see Sarah, who's standing in the back. Next week, next Friday, please join us for a first Friday Shabbat service. We're already into November, practically. And this first Friday Shabbat service will be celebrating our new members. The service starts at 6:15. As always, we have our oneg beforehand. And the service will be followed by a dinner for our members and guests. And please remember to register for the dinner next week so that there will be food for everyone who comes. You can register in the e-news or on the website calendar. However, new members only, skip the registration page and RSVP directly to Sarah Roper. Her email's programs@bethahabah.org.
And everyone should join us as we welcome all of our new members. We have quite a few of them. Wonderful.
I'm told that the rabbi ordered 4,000 sticker name tags.
I did order 4,000.
So let's start making some headway into those name tags, people.
And I will be, of course, mixing.
Oh, yes.
I will be, of course, mixing a signature cocktail for the fall and for our new members, and it will be a cranberry apple cider
whiskey
drink. Yes.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to call it Bruchim Habaim.
Oh, that's sweet. Yes. Bruchim Habaim is a way of saying welcome.
Right. The Bruchim Habraim brew.
Oh, God.
Bruchim.
Oh.
Abaim. Yes.
Wow.
You got it. Never mind.
You heard it here first. That's wonderful. Our first book group of the year is on Thursday, November 9th at 6 p.m. So start reading the book called The Weight of Ink by Rachel Kadish. The Weight of Ink is a wonderful book. I love it. Heather read it and she said she liked it. Other people have read it and they said they like it. Whether or not you come to book group, you should totally still read the book. Please do register if you want to come to book group, because it's going to be at Renata's house. And if you register, I'll actually tell you where that is and we'll discuss the book all together. And there will be snacks, which is why we need to know how many people there are. Our fall Congregational Israel Update and Discussion, which will be far more topical than we knew it would be when we originally scheduled it, will be Friday, November 10th, following Shabbat services. There's also, on Sunday, November 12th, a discussion on anti-Semitism with Rabbi Nagel. That's on that Sunday at 10 a.m. Again, far more topical than we knew it would be when we scheduled it, lo, these many months ago. Beck, by popular demand, that Sunday night, the 12th, our choir cabaret concert will be at 7 p.m. with Nosh starting at 6:30. And this year, soloists from the choir will sing songs by famous Jewish composers, Bert Bacharach, like raindrops keep falling on my head, and Michel Legrand, who composed the songs in Yentl, among other things. Lastly, do you think that we can pull off a Hamiltaschen, which would be a Hamilton-themed Purim spiel? If you want to be in the room where it happens, whether on or off stage, please, thanks Sarah Roper for that pun, please fill out the interest form, which has been linked in the e-news. Fill out that form by November 13th so that we know whether we can move forward with this amazing spiel idea. We just need to know we have enough people. For more information on all these and other events, please see your weekly e-news and the website calendar. Back to you, Rabbi.
It's time now do you want to come up? All right, well, it's time now for us to, let's say, a blessing over the bread so we can all eat. And I'm going to give it to your dad to hand out, and it's going to be all right. Let's all say the blessing together.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz.
And the bread and chocolate will be coming around to everyone as we celebrate Shabbat together. A little sweetness for Shabbat. And we can turn to our Shabbat programs for our closing song, L'Dor V'Dor.
We are gifts and we are blessings. We are history in
Please repeat after me. Adonai os.
Adonai os.
Le'amo yitain.
Le'amo yitain.
Adonai varech.
Adonai varech.
Et amo vashalom.
Et amo vashalom.
May God bless us all with health and strength.
May God bless us all with health and strength.
May God bless us all with peace.
May God bless us all with peace.
Amen.
Amen.
Shabbat shalom, everyone.
Shabbat shalom.